convenience. Whether you're looking for a new or quality pre-owned vehicle, we're ready to give you the best car buying experience possible. Need your vehicle serviced? We've got you covered. Our certified master technicians are ready for you in our state-of-the-art service center. Low prices, big selection, and committed to quality customer service. Visit us at 5585 Jefferson Davis Highway or online at terrylamberthyundai.com.
From the station that's on your side, this is News 12, First at 5.
Six at 5, a huge development in the Ellick Murdoch trial involving critical evidence. Stick around to find out what the state can use and how that changes their defense. Plus, an education bill stirring up major controversy. We'll have more on how the bill is aiming to dictate and restrict curriculum in South Carolina classrooms. But first, strong winds and a low.
Much more on that forecast in just about 10 minutes. Thanks, Riley. We're getting our first look inside the Colleton County Courthouse as lawyers clash over potential evidence in the double murder trial of Ellick Murdoch. Murdoch is charged in the June 2021 killings of his wife and son. Nick DeVille brings us up to speed on what's happened today.
The morning began with continued questioning of a fourth and final panel of prospective jurors. The work of seating a jury is going to continue tomorrow morning, but right now lawyers are inside hashing out whether or not certain ballistics evidence will be admissible during the course of this trial. Ellick Murdoch arriving this morning around 9 a.m. wearing a plaid shirt and khakis. He didn't respond to questions from reporters. We now have a list of potential witnesses that could testify at the trial. A list so long that it took presiding judge Clifton Newman about 12 minutes to read them to potential jurors. That list includes familiar names in the saga like Buster Murdoch, Alex's lone surviving son, and Curtis Eddie Smith, the man accused of shooting Murdoch in an alleged insurance fraud scheme.
A lot of time and money by both sides have gone into determining what the optimal juror is going to be in this case.
This afternoon, defense and prosecution battling over the alleged motive in this case.
He had been stealing for over a decade, 99 counts to date, and facing essentially life without parole on these particular financial accounts, and that's the significance of what he was trying to prevent from being exposed.
Defense attorney Dick Harpopian painted the Murdochs as the, quote, perfect family.
His theory, and this is sort of, is that he knew the jig was up, so he went home and blew the head off his son, and butchered his wife. There's not one shred of evidence there was any problems between any of them.
Judge Newman pumping the brakes on those arguments for now.
You got the jury arguments, and you're arguing multiple motions simultaneously.
Judge Newman this afternoon ruled against the state's pretrial motion to include certain financial crimes evidence as motive. That doesn't mean that the state won't be able to use that as evidence. It simply means that it's going to have to be taken up on a case-by-case basis as this trial unfolds. Reporting in Walterboro, Nick Neville, WIS, News 10.
Jury selection will continue tomorrow morning at 11 a.m.
And that's when defense and prosecution will have the opportunity to dismiss a certain number of jurors before setting on a final number of 12 jurors with 6 alternates. Well, a student was arrested yesterday for bringing a gun to the Performance Learning Center. Reports say it happened at around noon. According to a letter sent home to parents, the 17-year-old got into a fight with another student. The gun was found on him shortly after by a Richmond County School System police officer. The student is facing several misdemeanor charges and will be held to the standards of the Richmond County Code of Conduct.
Legislation that restricts what can and cannot be taught in South Carolina schools, that is back up for debate at the State House.
It's called the South Carolina Transparency and Integrity in Education Act. State House reporter Mary Green has the details from Columbia.
This new bill introduced this year is similar to what's already in state law, but on a temporary basis, written into the current state budget. This new bill would put that into permanent law with some changes, and it had its first hearing today. The bill would ban teaching concepts including one race, sex, ethnicity, color, or national origin is inherently superior to another, and that people are responsible for other actions committed in the past by members of their same race or sex. It would would also prohibit students and school staff from being required to participate in mandatory gender or sexual diversity training or counseling. One of the bill's sponsors says this is an issue he heard about a lot on the campaign trail last fall.
Many of my constituents are very concerned about what's the woke indoctrination of the students in government schools, and so it's a no-brainer.
The bill states it does not ban the fact-based discussion or instruction of controversial aspects of history or about the historical oppression of a particular group of people based on race, ethnicity, religion, etc. It also extensively outlines the complaint process if someone believes a school is in violation. That's different from the current temporary state law. Patrick Kelly, a high school teacher in Richland County, says he doesn't personally know of the banned concepts being taught in South Carolina classrooms, and he doesn't believe this bill would inhibit teaching state standards, but he worries about the climate around these issues.
So if you have a concern, address the concern with the individual involved, and don't paint with a broad brush that captures an entire profession at a moment where we're having a hard time recruiting and retaining teachers, in large part because teachers don't feel respected or heard.
The concept known as critical race theory is not directly mentioned in this legislation, but it is essentially alluded to. The State Department of Education has said critical race theory and the concepts that would be explicitly prohibited under this legislation are not part of state standards. But in previous years, some South Carolinians have testified they still are concerned they are being taught in some schools. Reporting from the State House, I'm Mary Green.
Previous iterations of this bill have included language banning teaching lessons that would make students feel uncomfortable.
That is not included in the current version of this bill. Another big case we're following, the Chatham County mother charged with killing her son. She is due back in court tomorrow. Leilani Simon has a motion hearing. Her attorneys are asking a judge to review whether disclosing family and children's service records might impact her right to a fair trial. Leilani is charged with murdering her son Quentin last October. She's also charged with concealing his death and lying to investigators. A Chatham County grand jury indicted her back in December.
Well, any minute now, a decision will be made for the wrongful death case involving the Murdoch family. 19-year-old Mallory Beach was killed in a boat crash back in 2019. Her family filed a civil suit naming nearly a dozen defendants, including the Murdoch family. Last week, a hearing was held in Lexington County near Columbia. During that hearing, attorneys for the Beach family requested certain people to be dropped from the lawsuit. Those people include Buster Murdoch, Alex's oldest son, and the estate of Maggie Murdoch, Alex's wife. Well, coming up on News 12, there may be a harsher law on the way for anyone who commits a crime with a gun. We have that latest proposal coming up after the break. Riley? And we do have the risk for severe weather and some very gusty winds heading into our Wednesday. Take a look at that first alert forecast just after the break.
Time 9-9.
It's a brand new year. Time to start fresh. With Milton Rubin Toyota.
Oh, yeah.
Fresh inventory is arriving daily. Lease a new 2023 Tacoma SR5 for $299 a month. Milton Rubin Toyota.
Now, your first alert weather.
Georgia. Still not zero for us, though, so just make sure you have a way to get to your safe place quickly in case you are placed underneath the tornado warning. As far as the power outage risk, this is mainly going to be driven by our pretty gusty winds, anywhere from 30 to 45 miles an hour, so that could cause a few tinier tree limbs to come down if they fall on top of power lines. Then we're talking about some outages, so that's going to be the main concern with a few isolated power outages out there on Wednesday. We're back to dry weather again Thursday. It is going to stay pretty breezy for us. Those temperatures will feel cooler. We'll only see high temps in the 50s Thursday and Friday, and that should extend into the weekend. Now, I mentioned our First Alert weather app just briefly, but we're going to go to First Alert meteorologist Anthony Carpino with more how you can stay informed using that.
Yeah, thanks for that, Riley. So if you do have our app downloaded, you can see usually get all of our alerts that you get throughout the day, either Riley's latest forecast, current conditions, or the hour-by-hour forecast. And when we talk about the chance for stronger storms, one of the tools that I like to use a lot is our interactive radar. So I'll pull that up here for us, and it's a zoomed-out view right now. You can see most of that storm activity is actually still off in Texas. You can see a lot of lightning just to the north of Jackson, Mississippi, and some severe weather. In fact, if I zoom in enough, I can actually click on one of those active tornado warnings right now, and those warnings will appear at the bottom of your screen, so you can actually see what you're placed under. In this case, this portion of Texas is under that tornado watch, and if I zoom it back out, we are on the drier side currently here in Georgia as well as in South Carolina, but as these storms get closer, this app is a great tool to have on your phone. You'll get up-to-the-minute alerts and the latest video from us, and you can also, if I pull this up really quickly, scroll to the bottom of the app. You can actually watch us live, the latest weather blog, and check out some of our live cameras that are placed around the Augusta area. Riley will have more on tomorrow's severe threat coming up in just a few minutes. Will, back over to you.
Thanks, Anthony. Guns, gangs, and gone. That's a newly filed bill that wants to impose a mandatory 10-year sentence for any crime committed with a firearm. State House reporter Abby Casores has more from gun rights groups and lawmakers who are for and against the bill.
Today at the Capitol, Senator Brandon Beach filed what he calls the 3 G's bill for gangs, guns, gone.
It won't stop everybody, but once you start making an example out of people, it would make some make better choices.
Maya Harrell lost her husband, Chris, last year. He owned a trucking company. He was training a new employee when the employee got into an argument with a third man. It ended in gunfire.
They pull the trigger out of fear and not out of logic or thinking. They just have a reaction and they shoot.
She wants stricter penalties for people who commit gun crimes. Senate Bill 7 would do just that. It would require any person who's holding or within arm's reach of their firearm while committing a violent crime to serve mandatory time.
You rob a convenience store at gunpoint and put a gun in somebody's face, then before you serve a day of that sentence that you're charged with, you're going to have a pre-enhanced 10-year minimum sentence that cannot be shortened by a district attorney.
Murder, rape, robbery, aggravated assault, all on that list, along with trafficking illegal drugs.
To do something to come down on stricter on gun violence.
Democrat Billy Mitchell disagrees. He believes all crimes are not created equally, and sentences should remain at the judge's discretion. He supports stricter gun laws as a better crime deterrent.
So it won't be as easy for criminals to be able to obtain, use, and commit the kind of crimes that he is trying to deter.
This bill also says that if someone has a blade more than 3 inches attempting to commit a violent felony, they'll face the same sentence. We reached down to the Prosecuting Attorney's Council of Georgia. They say they don't comment on any pending legislation. This bill will then be presented to the Senate and discussed. In Atlanta, I'm Abby Casores.
Live at 5, we're taking you to Atlanta. These are live pictures here of a small plane that landed on I-985. Now, according to our sister station, the plane took off around 3:25 from the Gwinnett County Airport in Lawrenceville, Georgia. You can see a very active scene. It looks like they are taking some barrels there into the truck.
Yeah, and it was in the air about 45 minutes, circled near Lake Lanier, and then went south towards the interstate. We don't know much yet about how many people were in the plane or why the plane landed. We'll keep you updated on this, and we'll be back after a short break.
Thanks for watching News 12 on your side.
It's a brand new year. Time to start with Milton Rubin Superstore.
Oh, yeah.
Fresh inventory is arriving daily.
We have plenty to choose. Every make and every model, price to move. Make a fresh start today. Milton Rubin Superstore.
People ask me,
call 1-800-CALL-KEN.
It's a brand new year. Time to start with Milton Rubin Superstore.
Oh, yeah.
Fresh inventory is arriving daily.
We have plenty to choose. Every make and every model, price to move. Make a fresh start today. Milton Rubin Superstore.
Grant me hope. Finding every foster child their forever home.
Well, every week we feature a different child in need of a loving home.
Layla may be young, but she has big dreams of becoming a vet. Meet Layla.
My name is Layla, and I am 12 years old. I like to read, and I love animals. I enjoy talking to my friends, watching movies, and reading. I like TV shows like Stranger Things. You never know what's gonna happen unless you, like, watched it all. Education matters the most, so you could be, like, what you want to be when you grow up. want to be a veterinarian or a surgeon. Right now I have two pets at home and they're chihuahuas. They're both girls. One is, her name is Cinnamon, and the other one is Royal. My favorite class in school is ELA. ELA is language arts. If you read a lot, then you can learn about history on the certain types of books. Knowing history helps us to understand the future. I think I can bring certain people some happiness because apparently everyone in my school seems to love me and they come and tell me all their problems. Why I like to have family around me is because they're very important to me. They're very interesting. Like, you're bored, you can go talk to them. My name is Layla, and I'm looking for a forever home.
Grant me hope, because every child deserves a loving home.
All right, we're back with our latest winner for our Plunkett Heating and Air Sunshade Giveaway. A big congratulations to Mr. Gary Williams from Augusta, Georgia. To get your own, just go to WRDW.com. We'll have a look at that First Alert forecast again just after the break.
It's a brand new year. Time to start fresh with Milton Rubin Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Save $8,500 off MSRP at $57,960 on a 22 Jeep Gladiator Willis for $49,460. Let's start something new, sales event at Milton Rubin Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
Attention.